Good morning, Twin Flame, Twin Souls, Veda Connections. This is Brainy Twin Gemini here for your reading November 23rd, 2019. This is a special reading. I'm not using cards today. I'm just strictly using my journal. The journal is the sacred thoughts of the DF and the DM. And yeah, so I will not be using cards today. And first and foremost, I want to thank you all so much for your love, your likes, your subs, the sense of community that's on my channel. It really, really warms my heart. And I want to thank you all so much. You know that this is a tough journey, and I love the way that you support each other on my channel. It just really, really means the world to me. You're also precious to me, and you always are in my prayers every single night. I pray for you all to have blessings on your journey. So, as many of you know, I channel all my energy in my journal in the morning, and I usually flip the cards, but I won't be today. But the cards always resonate with my journal. Every day I'm delivered signs and syncs. These signs and syncs are messages that are meant to be delivered to you. And so yeah, so I'm going to go with my signs and syncs for the last 24 hours. Lots of crazy things here in the last little bit. So I saw the number 711, 717, 1111, and I want to, like, I saw that on the time, the actual clock, but I wanted to go over, I have an auto rule set up at work, and emails go into this particular folder. And yesterday there was 1,111 emails in that folder. They were unread, I don't need to read them, but I was looking at that all day long. And when prior to you coming into physical unity, you will see this number quite frequently, 1111. You see it when you embark on the journey, but you also see it when you're getting closer to physical unity. So again, that my message to you is I saw that number 1111 all day long. So what I've been saying for many of you in this collective group, communication is coming in the fall with a long-term commitment in the winter. If you go to any of my previous videos, more specifically, I think it was on Thursday, there has been a lot of traction in this collective group, and I am so, so happy for all of you that are, you know, getting this physical unity, getting this communication. You have my blessings, and I truly, truly hope everything works out beautifully for you. I also saw the hawk, I'm sorry, I didn't go through the rest of the numbers. I saw 444, 333, and I saw 717 twice. I saw hawk, which I will elaborate in a minute, because the hawk spirit is a very, very profound animal to see, especially on this particular journey. But one thing I do want to bring to your attention, which I think is absolutely crazy and it is wild, and it's almost like the spirit knows that I'm not reading cards today. Because when I went out this morning to get a coffee, I brought my son with me, and he works at the coffee shop, and he was kind of like socializing with his friends there. And I listened, there was a number of songs that came on to the radio station that I listened to, and it was like the music was speaking to me. So there was about four or five songs that came to me on the way there and on the way back. So the first one was December by Collective Soul. So December being, you know, I've been saying long-term commitment in the winter. December is winter. Panic Attack by the Glorious Sons. I'll elaborate on that in a minute. Under Pressure by Queen and David Bowie. The Lion by Monster Truck. And lastly, Intergalactic by Beastie Boys. So December, Collective Soul, as I said, long-term commitment coming in. If you want to challenge me on this, go to Google, type in 97.7 iHeartRadio. You can see it for yourself. Panic Attack, the DMs are having a bit of a panic attack right now because you're standing in your power DF and you're moving away. Excuse me. So they are, you know, going through the sense of panic right now. So ironically how that song came on, I channeled that this morning with the actual energy. Under Pressure, they're under some pressure because they're wanting to get to you because of this panic, because you're standing in your power, because you're moving away. They're feeling a little bit of under pressure to get to you. the lion, exactly what the lion is. There's been a lot of fear with this particular divine masculine energy. And one thing, it will come out in my journal, but they have the courage and they have the strength to move forward. And a lot of it had to do with the fear of rejection. That's one of the biggest obstacles that they have to overcome in this journey is the fear of rejection. And for the DF, it is letting go. You're both doing it. My heart's racing here. There is like movement coming left, right, north, south, east, west is coming everywhere, all over the world. And then lastly, Intergalactic by Beastie Boys. Intergalactic talks about, a different dimension. When we start this journey, we go through an awakening and we go through different dimension. We go to what we call the sixth dimension. That's your third eye opening and your crown. So again, I elaborate this more in my journal, which I will be reading shortly. A couple of other things that I didn't put in my journal this morning is when I first woke up, I was very, very stuffy, couldn't breathe actually. And the third eye chakra actually affects the ears, the nose, and the eyes. And how this works is when I wake up with DF energy. Then I go and I meditate in a long Epsom salt bath for about 30 minutes and I channel DM energy. So I'm thinking that the DF energy, some of you might have been stuffed up. Maybe some of you are stuffed up and you've had somewhat of a headache. The headache is the crown chakra, which is located at the top of the head. And it governs the pineal gland and the upper brain. When developed, it brings us knowledge, wisdom, understanding, spiritual connection, and bliss. So DFs, if you're feeling that, I'm not sure if you are. It's gone now. I just felt it when I woke up this morning. It's completely gone. I'm not stuffed up anymore because after I meditated, it completely went away. And when I came, out of the DM energy, that's when I started to feel this sense of panic, this sense of, I guess that's the best way to put it, is they're like kind of having anxiety. So, so I'm going to get started. I'm going to read here. I wanted to go over the angel quickly. So I'm on Monday, I had told you crazy things happen to me and I got to do the hawk spirit because that's very important. Crazy things happen to me all the time. And these are messages, and they're messages to be delivered to you. About a week ago last Wednesday, I found this heart on the floor in my bedroom upstairs. And I didn't know where it came from. It was on my bedroom floor. I was actually putting laundry away. And I looked down and I thought it was from one of my bracelets. And it wasn't. So I just set it on the dresser. I didn't know where it came from. I couldn't even remember where it came from, to be quite honest. Last week, I was taking out some stuff, some decorations. And I pulled this angel out. This is an angel that I bought for my mother for Christmas several years ago. And when I looked at the angel, I realized that that heart, this heart here, it was my birthstone, which is an emerald, belonged to this angel. And I've still miffed to this. I don't know how it ended up on my floor upstairs. That's two flights of stairs. And that heart landed on, like, it was on the floor. And this was in a box, in a chest, in a cedar chest. So I have no idea how that heart got up there. But the one thing I resonate with this heart, it's my mother saying to follow your heart and follow your intuition and trust your inner guide. Very, very important message here with that. Just like I said, crazy, crazy stuff always happens. But these are messages that are meant to be delivered to you. I want to go over the hawk because yesterday when I was driving to work, this hawk flew right in front of my car. Beautiful big bird, scared me. I did not want to hit this hawk. I was like scared and elated at the same time because I know how profound a hawk is and the symbolism behind it. And when a hawk swoops into your life, be ready for a whole new level of developing your mind and spirit. They're messages from angels, divas, and other divine. It's not unusual for hawk spirit to inspire you when you begin to work with divine methods. And it also reminds you to trust your inner guide and higher self. Don't brush off gut instincts. Hawk medicine begins with observation and ends with swift, decisive, and successful movement. Don't be surprised if you find your psychic abilities growing. The universe is trying to send you a message. Pay attention to everything, and you'll have a higher perspective on some things that have been holding you back until you get the big picture. You could remain stagnant. Two things here that I resonate: DFs. It's letting go and moving on with your life and surrendering to the connection, and DMs. You know, letting go of that fear of rejection. So very, very important messages. It's like the universe knew I wasn't reading these cards. I was kind of having a little bit of anxiety myself because I didn't know, you know, how I was going to maneuver this video, to be quite honest. But I'm just going to get started now with my journal. And it, for the DF energy, it's kind of a mixed bag because it's like, we and I, it's just the way the pen goes to the paper. When I channel very, very quickly. I'll count the number of pages I have. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6.5 pages. And it takes time. And like, again, it's pen to paper. It's spirit. It's a number of things. So what I meant to write is what I meant to write. Okay. So I'm going to read here. In the last several days, there's been a lot of confusion as to whether this connection is real or if it's just a fabrication. It is very difficult and not at all easy. There is some frustration and longing in the last couple of days. And even though the DM never meant to hurt the DF, the fact remains he did. And it's not acceptable behavior at all. This is a journey, I get it, and it's a journey of self-love, self-worth, and unconditional love, giving with no conditions. I have zero expectations, and I absolutely know the value of self-worth. I know that the DM came to wake me up, and I never knew what the value of my self-worth was until I met him or her. He treated me like a goddess, a princess, a queen. Time stood still. It hasn't been easy, and there has been many tears, and although I know he never meant to hurt me, the fact is he did. And this felt like someone ripped my heart out and stomped on it. But I suppose it's part of the process of healing, learning not to be codependent, and growing spiritually to be the best version of oneself. It's so easy to become a prisoner to this. And although I have taken back the power, it's very easy to get sucked up into that black hole again and become prisoner to it. It takes incredible strength to keep moving forward, but we are, and we are moving away from the prison that chains, and the chains are off. And at the end of the day, the behavior is not right, but it's forgiven because it's a journey of oneself. To heal those wounds. Life is a journey, and many of us have wounds, wounds that we may not even be aware of. But those wounds need to heal in order to evolve in this journey. We have to raise our frequency with oneself and be the highest sense of ourself. Once you go through those layers, then instinctively you just want to move away from those prison walls and take back the power you have. At the end of the day, no one forced you to be a prisoner to it but yourself. And breaking free and letting go is probably the most difficult element of this journey. You have to evoke that power from the DM. It was never his to have. And once you do, there is a shift. And once you stand in your power, know what your worth is, the physical union no longer matters. Because essentially, you have union within yourself. You are twin souls, one soul split into two bodies. You're never apart. It's impossible. And once you free yourself of that prison, it will come to you. Some are further behind and still have to awaken. But again, it's part of the process. And regrettably, we may not fully awaken, including the DM, because DM energy is egocentric and slightly immature. You truly have to understand this journey and that you came to each other at a time in your life to rattle the soul. The soul was sleeping or dormant, and your twin comes in to awaken you. An awakening can be frightening because you're not clear about what is going on. But the one thing for absolute certainty, you come together to wake each other up, and usually no other reason than that. It's the most raw, vulnerable type of love and unexplainable to most, and even to oneself. But as you evolve, all the answers come to you. This is not an easy journey, but it's not meant to be. Anger, frustration go with the journey. And sometimes you take two steps forwards and one backwards. It's part of the journey too. Both the DF and the DM have to do the work. No one is impartial to it. The hardest part of the DF's journey is to surrender and let go. The DF energy is nurturing and loving. It's natural to want to nurture that love, but it does suffocate the DM. It's a crazy, crazy journey, and it tampers with one's sanity, but it's part of the awakening as well. Once you awaken as a person, your third eye, sixth sense, kicks in. It's located in the center of your forehead, and it governs the pituitary gland, the lower brain, nervous system, the ears, nose, and eyes. When developed, it empowers our intuitive abilities and helps us see clearly the big picture. Once that third eye opens, your intuition is stronger, and you should be trusting your intuition more and more. You just instinctively start connecting the dots. The answers come automatically. You know what needs to be healed and what needs to be cleared. It hasn't been an easy journey, but it's a true blessing because it brings a love we've never experienced, and the lovemaking is pure, raw, and vulnerable with no inhibitions. It's been tough, but truly fated, and it's an absolute blessing, even though at times it doesn't seem so. It actually forces us to be better, and if we don't grow and learn our lessons, then a journey will not evolve. I am truly grateful for this sacred blessing, and I love my DM like no other. No conditions, just pure love. I'm standing in my power now, and I have realized that life truly does go on. And I trust my intuition, and I know the outcome, and I know the outcome for many. This is actually happening for many, and I feel ultimately blessed to share this journey with so many others. DFs, never forget what this journey is about. Relinquish control. Love you. Know your value. You are all beautiful, precious souls. You deserve the world. You are a goddess, a princess, and a queen, and never, ever forget that. Okay, so that's for you, DF. You're doing great. I'm so proud of you, standing in your power, shifting this energy. Again, that headache, that stuffiness, I feel like it's coming from you today. Your third eye is opening. You know, your crown is opening. Hawk spirit. Many of you on this journey are very, very intuitive. You are empaths. You're light workers. Your indigo adults, your sliders, like there's you are very gifted, okay? Good job. Going to DM what I channeled in my journal. So we're getting started here. This is DM energy, okay? I love you so much. I miss you like crazy, girl. You mean the world to me, and I think of you always. I'm sorry, DF, for hurting you. You know I'm never meant to. It tears me up every time I think of how I hurt you. I'm not proud of what I've done, and the one thing I regret the most about this crazy love journey is hurting you. You have to trust me, girl. You do. I cried for you when I ran. It was one of the hardest choices I had to make, but I just had to. It was never you. You're an absolute goddess to me always, and always have been, but I was so fucked up. None of it seemed real to me. It seemed like a crazy dream. It just didn't make sense, and I could not rationalize the feelings nor the overwhelming emotions. You came to me like a storm, girl. I never knew that you would captivate me like you did. It's crazy, girl. From the moment I saw you, I knew that there was something about you. I just knew, but I couldn't accept it, and I was in complete denial. My life was a mess, DF, and you were so perfect and stable. I couldn't give you what I wanted to, and I had deep anxiety over it. I truly did not know what you saw in me, and I never knew. that I would feel this way. It's crazy, this journey, but I just knew you were going to be my wife. But I couldn't do it. I wasn't ready. You deserve the world, girl, and I truly felt you deserved better. There was so much crap in my life, so much you don't know, but I was protecting you and the sacred connection. I'm coming to tell you everything I am, and you will understand my reasons once I explain it all. I'm going to tell you how I feel because I wasn't honest with my feelings, but I think you already knew how I felt. You are the absolute love of my life, and I did not know what love truly was until I met you. You're an absolute blessing to me. You help me in ways you don't even know, but I'm coming to tell you everything. I had a messed up life, and it wasn't easy, girl, but I truly never knew what you saw in me. My self-worth was tanked, and I didn't realize it until I met you. You treated me like a king, and I realize that I'm worthy of your love now. I'm sorry for the hurt, my precious angel, but I had to clean up my mess. I know what this is, and I have for quite some time. I'm fully awakened to it, but it's messed me up, man. I feel like I'm losing my mind, girl. Hearing voices, I hear you all the time. I feel you all the time. This is some messed up shit. But don't lose the faith, girl. This is our journey. I feel your disappointment, and I'm sorry, but I'm working extremely hard to give you the life you deserve. Don't ever doubt the love, girl. Be patient and breathe. I feel you slipping away, and it scares me. I've been spying on you, but I need to know what you are up to. I haven't been fair to you at all. You never deserved any of this, but we weren't ready, and we needed to heal. I'm coming for you, and you are going to be my wife. That is happening, girl. I'm coming to get you, and I'm never letting you go. I appreciate your patience, and I admire your strength. You are right. You are so right. I can't read my own writing. You are so right for me, girl. I'm working on it, but the biggest obstacle I've had to overcome was the fear of rejection. I'm over it, girl. Your power has given me the strength and that courage. I cannot thank you enough. I cherish our memories, our love. I'm a much better person now. You helped me see things I needed to change. I have tapped into my creative side again because you've given me hope and inspiration. You truly are my destiny, girl. I admire your beauty, and I'm extremely grateful to have met you. I love you very much, DF, and I can't wait until we start our new journey. I am going to surprise you, girl, so be ready. I love you, girl. Don't lose the faith. Okay? So that's what I have for you today. I hope you enjoyed this special journal or reading today. And again, thank you so much for the love, the likes, the subs. And I love you all so much. And I wish you nothing but blessings on your journey. Okay? Have a great day, folks.